From place to place and time to time, we see the enemies of Islam circling around the Muslims in every single place to attack them from every single direction. There are many, many solutions offered. There are many fingers pointed. It is the fault of so-and-so. And yet, almost never, do you hear the people actually tell people the real reason why this is happening and the very, very simple solution to stop it happening. There is no evil and no trial and no fitna that will befall this ummah except that Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam explained in the clearest of terms the cause and the solution for it.
Today, my brothers, we live in a time and in an era where nobody wants to put their hands up and say and take responsibility. When men came to Ali bin Abi Talib, they said to him, how come in the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab, mashallah, everything was going well, Islam was expanding, money was coming in, and why is it now, oh Ali, now during your time, we see the fitna that's happening around? You know what he said? He said, because in the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab, he had men like me around him. Whereas now in my time, I have men like you around me.
The source of trials and tribulations are what our own hands have earned. Corruption has appeared on land and at sea. بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ, by what the hands of men have earned. So many times, read the history, Ya Ikhwan, read the history of Gaza, read the history of what happened in Palestine. By Allah, it was not the strength of the enemy that gave them Palestine, nor was it their support from the wider countries like the US and the UK and France. We gave it to them. We took it with our own hands and we gave it to them on a plate. Because the Muslims were so corrupt that they were out committing zina and stealing and lying and cheating, and so far away from their deen, they were led by a Shuyu'i Ba'athi communist. And when the Israeli people found out, they simply bribed them into giving them the location of the planes and letting them leave them out, and then they destroyed them. What help did you want Allah to give them against the people who were fighting them? The same thing that happened in Uhud, and it happened again, and it happened in Hunayn, and again in the Quran, we are told it comes from your own sins. Corruption has appeared on land and at sea by what the hands of men have earned. You can't change the sins of the people, but you can change your own. And if you change your own, then Allah Azza wa Jal will help you in your local area, your locality, in your family. When each individual person turns back to Islam and turns back to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah, Allah Azza wa Jal will give us victory over them. And this is the real solution.
Our good deeds of feeding an orphan, of clothing a person, Ya Ikhwati, these are our points of success. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us, because of our taqwa and because of our success points, our mafaz, our good deeds in this dunya.
We tend to complain to others about our state, hoping they may fulfill our need. Allah is also known as Al-Mujib, the one who responds to your call whenever you call upon Him. Allah Al-Mujib, the one who gives you whatever is best for you whenever you ask Him. We have to understand the concept of dua, not just from the etiquettes that you should fulfill, which is wonderful, but what we need to know is, whom are you asking from? So don't ever underestimate your dua. Know whom you're asking from.
Our good deeds of feeding an orphan, of clothing a person, Ya Ikhwati, these are our points of success.
We have to understand the content of dua.
The source of trials and tribulations are what our own hands have earned.